In this video, I'm going to show you how to grade your drone footage and make it look amazing. We've got this shot. It is shot on DJI. First things first, color space. The timeline color space is Davinci Wide Gamut. The output is Rec 709 2.4. Step one, I create a color space transform. We want to change DJI to Davinci Wide Gamut. DJI, Davinci, and none. Now, normally, you would create a CST there that changes it from Davinci Wide Gamut to Rec 709, but I don't actually like what Davinci does with DJI footage, so I made two LUTs that I always use. If you don't know how to download LUTs and install them, just follow the link below, download the files, and you go to Project Settings, open LUT folder, you paste it into that folder, you come back here, and you click Save. And then when you go down to LUT, you look for drone LUTs, and you'll find these two. So the two I use is the normal one, which is blue and green, and I have another one that's blue and yellow. It creates more of a contrasting palette, which I personally like a lot. For this example, let's use green and blue. So this is what you get out of the box. Green, blue, looking good. First node, we'll do exposure. The second node, we're going to do ratio. In a previous video, I know I talk about exposure, contrast, and saturation and balance. You can do it like this. I just like to do it in this type of way because it's faster. Exposure. We can use this offset, or we can go to the HDR and use this guy. Or we're just going to keep it simple. Look at the histogram. How is it spread out? It's spread out pretty well. I'm going to darken it a bit so the offset go down, and I'm going to leave it there. Now the ratio. Ratio is contrast. So I'll go down with my offset. I go up with my gain a bit. I go up with my offset and I'm looking here. I'm going to leave it there. Now this is where the secret stuff comes in. I'm going to make two parallels, two nodes in a parallel. I'm going to call this cold and warm. So I try to create as much depth as I can in shots. And with depth, if you can get contrasting colors, it'll make your image look better. So in this image, you can already see there's a lot of blue here and there's a lot of green here. Let's say I wanted to make it even bluer up here. One way would be you can go down here. You can increase the saturation of blue. But sometimes you have drone footage and there's no blue in there. Another way is you create a mask, right? Like a mask. And let's just do a crude mask. And go offset, and we're going to pump in blue. But this feels super unnatural. So the technique I use, I'm going to reset that, is I create a mask. I go aspect 100. I soften. I rotate. I already know blue is up here. And then I go to my temperature. I'm going to crank it colder, colder, colder. And I'm going to do the opposite for warm. I'm going to create a mask. Aspect is 100. And just soften it up. I'm going to rotate it, I'm going to pull it down, and temperature, I'm going to crank up. Now, it all depends on how crazy you want to go, and I'll leave that up to you. But for this example, I'm going to stay right here. So just with these two, if I turn it on and off, we've already created a nice contrasting color. What I could also do is I'm going to add another parallel, and I can see this little house. It's kind of disappearing in here. So if you have a drone shot, and you kind of figure out what's the subject. This could be the subject, or the house could be the subject. You kind of want to make it stand out a bit. I always soften it up. Now you can see this house is pretty warm because we have a warm temp floating over here. And if we go in the opposite direction, we make it cool again, it's going to stand out a bit more in a natural way. So this technique is all about temperature, and sometimes you'll also use tint. I don't use offset or gain or gamma or lift. I just use temperature and tint. That's all I use. It reacts with your image really well in a very natural way. The last thing, the icing on the cake, is you add texture pop. And I really like what this does to the image. I'm going to go advanced. I'm going to show you exactly what happens. And I'm just going to play with tiny. You see how much detail comes out there. And it doesn't look unnatural. Now if I zoom out and I turn all of this on and off, see with this LUT, we're going from here to here. And these contrasting colors create a nice dynamic look in your footage. Now we can actually just swap these. If you don't want the green and blue, you can go drone, blue and yellow. Now you have a completely different look. And obviously, if you want to change hues or whatever you want to do, you just do it inside of here. You're working in DaVinci White Gamut right here. Let's try another clip. CST, color space transform. We take it from DGI to DaVinci White Gamut. DaVinci White Gamut. And for this, I'm going to use my blue and yellow. Okay, the first node we can go, exposure. Second one we can go, ratio. Ratio is always just contrast. And then after that, we can go the parallels again. And after that, we're going to go texture again. So here, we go cold, warm, texture. Okay, exposure. I'm going to have a look here. I'm using my offset. I'm just trying to get it in the middle. Okay, ratio. I'm going to go offset and gain. It's the same as contrast. So offset down, gain up, offset down, gain up. Just spreading this out, offset down, gain up until I'm happy with the image. Okay, now I'm going to go cold. It's already cold up here. I'm going to double down on that. Going to go 100. I'm going to go here. Going to go here. I'm going to rotate it. You should play around with these masks, by the way. If you play around with these masks and the level of temperature, you can get some very interesting type of drone shots. It doesn't always have to be a very pushed look. It's pretty versatile. Now we have this guy. Cold. I'm going to go temperature. I'm going to go left. So I'm going to add cold and warm. Going to soften it up, rotating, pulling down. And here the temperature is going the opposite direction. Okay, this shot looks pretty good. It is definitely a type of look. If you don't like the type of color it pushes out here, you can always just create an extra node here and play with the hue versus hue. It's just a starting point, right? But for the example, we're going to keep it like this. Okay, this looks kind of cool. I'm going to crank this even more. I'm going to get a really, really pushed look. I'm looking at the histogram. Everything is still inside, which is good. Maybe I'll pull it down a bit like that. Maybe I'll even rotate it. Let's see what it looks like here. Yeah, maybe this is not bad. Maybe I'll do it like that. And this guy, I'm going to rotate a bit more like this. Yeah, that looks good. Let's just say I'm happy with that. And then lastly, you go texture, texture pop, advanced. And then I'll show you what happens. Tiny, tiny, we're going to go tiny. Tiny, we're going to go tiny. See what that does. It's minimal, but on the grand scheme of things, your image looks so much better. It's way better than sharpening it or anything else. And now you have a kind of a Lord of the Rings type of vibe. You can even, if you want to, this looks a little bit strange, so you might even want to track this. We go down here. It doesn't want to track, so you go frame, there, there. And now, whoop, now it's tracked properly. There we go. And just to show you, these LUTs are interchangeable. If you don't want the yellow and blue, let's see what the green and blue looks like. And so this is green and blue. It looks a bit more natural. And that's how I grade my drone footage. Like I said in the video, if you do want to grab these LUTs I made and play around with them, I will put a link in the description below.